Friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Pariyani and in today's session we will learn about how to pass journal entries using accounting rules. So let's begin. In order to pass the journal entries, first you need to understand the basic rules of accounting or rules of debit and credit which are used to pass these journal entries. So let us try to understand the rules first. So these are rules of debit and credit, also known as golden rules of accounting or basic rules of accounting. So without knowing this, you cannot pass the journal entries. So a short revision for these rules. If you want the detailed explanation about this topic, you can watch my previous video. You can go to my channel's playlist and you will find the video there. So now let us start. So basically there are three types of accounts and every account has its own rules. So first is personal account. Personal account deals with persons. So remember one thing, not only persons but also institutions and companies comes under personal account because they are treated as artificial persons in accounts. They have the separate existence. So the rules of personal account says that debit the receiver and credit the giver. So in a transaction, the person who is the receiver, he should be debited. That account should be debited. And the person who is the giver should be credited. So this is the rule for personal account. Next, real account. Real account deals with all type of assets. So here you need to remember one thing, that is assets comes under real accounts, but liabilities does not comes under real account. Liabilities are related to persons, hence it comes under personal account. So all types of assets are dealt with real accounts. The real account rule says that debit what comes in and credit what goes out. So if anything is coming into the business, that should be debited, and if something is going out of the business, that should be credited. Next, nominal account. So debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. Nominal account deals with expenses and losses, incomes and gains. If there are any expenses and losses, that should be debited, and if there are any incomes and gains, that should be credited. So if you clearly understand these rules, you can pass any type of journal entry. So now let us go to the problem. So journalize the following transactions in the books of Himanshu. So Himanshu is a businessman. He has performed all these financial transactions which are needed to be journalized. So first transaction, that is year 2005, December 1st. On December 1st, Himanshu started business with cash rupees 75,000. So Himanshu is starting the business with cash. So how will you pass this entry? So let us try to understand. This is just the rough work. So this is for your understanding purpose. So on December 1, Himanshu started business with cash rupees 75,000. Right? So here for every transaction there will be two accounts. One is debit account and one is credit account. So we need to understand which is debit and which is credit. So in this transaction the two accounts are, one is cash account and he is bringing the cash into the business. It means that he is bringing the capital into the business, right? Himanshu is bringing the capital into the business. Hence the other account is capital account. So now cash is an asset, right? So assets are dealt with real account. What the real account rule says? Real account rule says that debit what comes in and credit was what goes out. So cash is an real account and he is bringing the cash. It means that cash is coming inside the business. So cash comes in, hence it should be debited. Next, capital account. Capital is a liability, right? So it comes under personal account. So Himanshu is giving the capital to the business, hence he is the giver. So it should be credited. Rules of personal account is that debit the receiver and credit the giver. So the giver, that is capital account, should be credited. So how to record this in the books of journal? So let us try to understand that. So this is the format of journal book of accounts. So this is the date column, this is particulars column, this is LF, it means ledger folio. This is just the page number of the ledger books. This is debit column, debit amount column, and this is credit amount column. So on December 1, 2005, December 1, the entry is cash account debtor and capital account creditor, right? So cash account debtor to capital account. So mention the same amount on both the sides. So 75,000 and 75,000. So this is how you pass the journal entries. So after the first transaction is completed, you need to write the narration. So narration is nothing but just a short description of the transaction. So you can write that being business started with cash. So the first entry is completed. So next entry. On December 7, purchased goods for cash rupees 10,000. So on December 7, purchased goods for cash. Here the two accounts are, one is cash account and the other is purchase account. So write down first purchase account and cash account. So we are purchasing something, means it should be an asset, right? And so it comes under real account. So purchase means goods are coming inside the business, so it comes in, hence it should be debited. And we are purchasing by paying the cash, so cash is also an asset. It also comes under real account, and cash is going out because we are making the payment, so it goes out and it should be credited. So the journal entry will be on December 7, purchase account debtor to cash account, and write the same amount on both the sides, that is 10,000 and 10,000. So now narration, being goods purchased for cash. So second entry is completed. Now the third entry. On December 9, sold goods to Swati rupees 5,000. So on December 9, sales are made. So here the two accounts are, one is Swati account and one is sales account. So here we are using the name as Swati's account, because here we are making the sales for not on the cash basis. Here the name of the person is mentioned. So if in a transaction the name for whom the goods sold is mentioned, that will be treated as credit transaction. So here the two accounts are sales account and Swati account. So write down sales account and Swati account. So remember one thing, whenever the name of the person is given in the transaction for purchase or sale, that will be known as credit basis transaction. There you cannot take the cash account. Here you need to take the name of the person and its account should be maintained. So sales. Sales means some asset is going out of the business. Sales are the assets, right? So it comes under real account. Sales means some goods are going out of the business, hence they are goes out, so they should be credited. And Swati account. Swati, she is the receiver, right? Swati is the person. Swati is the name of the person, so it comes under personal account. And Swati is receiving the goods, so she is the receiver, hence it should be debited. So record it. On December 9. So here you need to remember one thing, that while recording the transaction, always the debit side should be up and credit side should be down. You cannot record first credit side upwards. So record it. Swati account debtor to sales account, and mention the same amount, that is 5,000. So the narration being goods sold to Swati. So the next transaction, on December 12, purchased furniture for rupees 3000. So here, see the transaction on date 7, here we purchased goods. So goods can be any type of goods, specifically it is not mentioned. Hence we have taken the purchase account into the consideration. But here in the transaction on the date 12, here it is specifically mentioned that furniture is purchased. Hence we should take the furniture account, not the purchase account. So on December 12, the two accounts will be furniture account and cash account. So in the question it is not mentioned that the furniture is purchased on credit basis. If nothing is mentioned, it should be treated as it is a cash basis transaction. Hence the cash account is taken into consideration. So furniture is an asset, right? It comes under real account. So furniture is coming into the business because we are purchasing the furniture. Hence it comes in, it should be debited. Cash is also in real account. Real account. We are paying the cash for the purchase of furniture. So cash is going out. Hence it should be credited. So record it. On December 12th. Furniture account debtor to cash account. So the amount is rupees 3000. So mention it, 3000 on both the sides. So narration being furniture purchased on cash. Okay, so next transaction, on December 18th, cash received from Swati in full settlement. So look at the previous entries, previous transactions. On December 9th, we have sold goods to Swati on credit, right? So we sold goods for rupees 5000. So on December 18th, she is giving the amount, that is cash for the goods that were being sold to her. So she is giving in full settlement. Full settlement means the accounts of Swati are going to be closed. So for she had to pay ₹5,000, but the settlement is made between the both the parties that they agreed to pay ₹4,000. So enter it on December 18th. Cash received from Swati in full settlement. So here two accounts are, one is cash account, the other is Swati account. So cash account and Swati account. So cash is an real account, right? Real account, because it is an asset. So when Swati is making the payment to us, the cash is coming in. It comes in. So it should be debited. And Swati. Swati is a person, right? So it is personal account. And Swati is the giver. The giver. So it is credited. So record it on December 18th. Cash account. That are ₹4,000. So here you need to remember one thing, that is full settlement is made and Swati had to pay ₹5,000 to us, but now she is paying 4,000. So the difference amount, that is 5,000 minus 4,000, 1,000 will be treated as discount. Discount allowed to Swati. So here you need to take that entry. So in this transaction there are three accounts. The second is discount account. So discount allowed, it is an expense for the company, right? So it comes under nominal account. It is an expense, hence it should be debited ₹1,000 and to Swati account ₹5,000. So whenever there is a full settlement and if any less amount is paid or received, then the difference amount will be treated as discount allowed or discount received. So write the narration: being cash received from Swati on full settlement. Next transaction. On December 19th, paid for trade expenses ₹700. So here we are making the payment. So one account will be cash account and the other will be trade expenses account. So record it. December 19. Cash account and trade expenses account. So cash is an asset, so it is real account. So here we are making the payment. So the cash is going out, right? So it goes out and it should be credited. And trade expenses. Trade expenses comes under nominal account, right? So nominal account rule says that debit all expenses and losses and credit all incomes and gains. So trade expenses are kind of expenses. So it is nominal account. And it is expenses, hence it should be debited. On December 19th, so trade expenses account debtor to cash account. So the amount is ₹700. So narration: being trade expenses spade. Next entry. So on December 25, deposited into bank rupees 16,000. So here we are making the deposit into the bank. So the two accounts are, one is bank account and another one is cash account, because we are depositing the money into the bank. So on December 25, one is bank account and cash account. So bank, it is an institution, right? It is an artificial person. So it comes under personal account, and we are depositing the money into the bank. So bank is receiving the money, hence it is the receiver, and it should be debited. Cash is a real account, and cash is going out because we are depositing the money into bank. So cash is going out, so it goes out, it should be credited. On December 25, bank account debtor to cash account, amount rupees 16,000. So next, on December 28th, paid rent rupees 1,000. So here the two accounts are, one is rent account and we are making the payment, hence it is, one is cash account. So on December 28th, rent account and cash account. So here we are making the payment for rent. Rent is our expense, right? Hence it comes in nominal account. It is an expense, so debit it. And cash is a real account. Cash is going out because we are making the payment. So it goes out and credit it. So write the narration for this. Being cash deposited into bank. Next, December 28. So rent account debtor to cash account. Enter the amount, rupees 1,000. So write narration. Being rent paid. So the last entry, on December 30th, paid salary rupees 15,000. So salary, here the two accounts are salary account and the cash account, right? We are making payment again. So on December 30th, the two accounts are salary account and cash account. So salary is our expense, right? We have to pay salaries to our official staff. So it is an expense. It comes under nominal account. Expense and debit it. Cash is going out. It is a real account. Goes out and credit it. Now record it. On December 30th, salary account debtor to cash account. So the amount is 1500. On both sides. So write narration. Being salaries paid. So now all the transactions are completed. Okay guys, so the total on both the sides will be 1,17,200. So here you need to remember one thing, that is the total on debit side and credit side should be same. So in journal entry problem, the total should be same on the both the sides. So these were very few simple, basic and commonly used journal entries. In my next video, I am going to discuss another problem relating to journal entries. So don't forget to watch the second part of journal entry accounting video. Okay, we'll see you there. Till that, you subscribe to my channel. Also press the bell button so that you can get the notification. We'll see you there. Till that, happy learning.